Hi, are you an architecture student that's stuck taking calculus but don't really get what it's about? When you hear the lecturer mention pie, do you get hungry? And if you hear that corny sine sin trig joke one more time, you just might do that? Then welcome, this is just for you.
Man, why I gotta take this calculus class? I feel like architecture is more artistic, you know, more free-spirited and knowing a bunch of numerical values. But more for engineers, really, and those in the more technical field. How could we know that calculus would help us be more creative in this field?
Well, actually, Brandon, calculus can be used for a variety of purposes in architecture. One of these is being able to compute the areas and the value to calculate the quantity of materials and the type of materials needed for a project.
At the most basic level, calculus is used to calculate the area of an irregular shape or the volume of a solid surface. Both of these can readily be extended to the field of architecture. If you were to build a rectangular structure, calculating the square footage is a simple matter. But if one or more of the walls are curved, for example, you'll need to use calculus to determine the area of the structure. You would also use calculus to figure out how much concrete would be needed to pour those curved walls.
Wait a minute. Who are you? Go
ahead. Lee's right. See, a common complaint of most bored math students, such as yourself, is, of course, that what they are learning won't have any real-world value. Architecture blends several subjects together, including art, physics, geometry, and calculus. Since calculus is used for examining forces over time, it is the main reason why buildings don't topple over in hurricanes and heating systems don't overload in the winter. Get it? Good.
Oh, I see what you're saying. I see. Come on, girl. How can calculus supposed to help me do this? I just did this by hand, you know? It's just creativity.
Brandon, listen. Calculus was developed in the 17th century by many scientists, as you can see. In a nutshell, you can say that calculus is the mathematical study of how things can change in the physical universe. You're onto something though, Brandon. Taking a class in calculus itself doesn't teach you how to design buildings, but it does give an architect a language to use when designing structures and for understanding how the forces, like gravity and wind, would affect them.
Yeah, I think I got it now. I think I understand.
But please be aware that one can certainly be a good architect without the 100% working knowledge of calculus. But if you do understand the fundamentals of calculus, you will have a better understanding of architectural forms and building systems.
As an architect, it is required to calculate an estimate on the amount of material needed in order to complete a project. These estimates can range from the square footage required to estimate the amount of material needed to complete a flooring process such as wood flooring or tiling. The importance behind this section is mandatory, since it allows an architect to provide its clients with exactly how much of a material they will need and ensures that no lawsuits would be made towards that architect on the grounds of giving a terrible estimation on the cost of the project. Mathematics can be used to calculate the square footage for a large amount of shapes. For the figures shown in this video, it would be a simple process to calculate the square footage for each individual room by simply using length times width, which would give you the area. But what if we added a back porch to our building? Furthermore, instead of making this porch a rectangle or square, what if we added a curve to one of its sides? Well, this is exactly where calculus comes in to save the day and makes an architect's life more simple. The Riemann sum is a concept in calculus that allows you to estimate an area under a curve. For the floor plan shown in this video, we can easily use it to estimate the area this shape takes up. In its most simplistic form, the Riemann sum is just the process of adding rectangles within the curve to estimate the area. And it would be safe to assume that the more rectangles you add, the more precise your estimation will be for the area. So let's say we have a porch that has a base of 8 feet 0 inches, and let's also give it two heights for its sides, those sides being 4 feet 0 inches and 7 feet 0 inches. To make our estimation more accurate, we can divide our porch and make one of our sections a rectangle, and find the area of that, which would be area equals length times width, equaling to 32 feet squared. Since we have these measurements, we can now use the Riemann sum to calculate the area for the upper section. For this example, we will use an even amount of rectangles for our estimation. Once you have an understanding of simple functions used in mathematics, you can easily see that our curve takes the shape of the common function square root of x. After realizing this, we would simply plug in the heights for each rectangle. For our smallest rectangle, we would plug in 1, which would also give us 1. Thus, the area of rectangle 1 would be length times width, which is 1 times 2, which is 2 feet squared. For our second rectangle, we would plug in 2, thus giving us 1.42. The area of rectangle 2 would equal to 1.42 times 2, equaling to 2.84 square feet. For our third rectangle, we would plug in 3, resulting in 1.73. Thus, the area for our third rectangle would be 1.73 times 2, resulting in 3.46 feet squared. Lastly, for our fourth rectangle, we would plug in 4. The square root of 4 is 2, so the area of our fourth rectangle would be 2 times 2, which results in 4 feet squared. For the total area of the upper section, we would simply add our real numbers together, which would result in the answer 12.3 feet squared. We would then add that 12.3 to 32, which would equal 44.3 feet squared.